Hello students, how are you? I think so all we are fine at our home. So in today's video we will discuss about some commercial cells. Commercial cells means the cells which can be used for the commerce purpose, which can be sold in the market. We know about the electrochemical cell, the cell in which the chemical energy changes into electrical energy. But in the formation of the electrochemical cell, we use the salt bridge, and we have the two half cells. The internal resistance of the salt bridge is very much high, so it gives a sharp voltage drop. We get the low amount of the current, and it cannot be easily handled. That cell was not a compact cell. So we want to prepare some cells which can be used for the selling purpose, which can be easily handled, which have the low resistance value. Those cells are called commercial cells. Actually, in our 12th class we discuss about the three type of the cell: primary cell, second is the secondary cell, and third one is the fuel cell. Primary cell, secondary cell, and fuel cell. In the primary cell, the redox reaction means the reaction occurring at the anode and cathode. Redox reaction, reduction reaction and oxidation reactions occurs only once a time. Means reaction occurring at the anode and cathode cannot be reversed. Cell becomes dead after some time. In the secondary cells are the rechargeable cells, which can be recharged, which can be reused by just reversing the redox reaction. And for the reversing of the redox reaction, we have to make that cell as electrolytic cell. Means in the recharging of the secondary cell, we have to supply electrical energy, and that electrical energy will change into the chemical energy form. Well, third one is the fuel cell. Fuel cell is the cell in which the combustion of the fuels, the energy is obtained, and that energy is used to convert into the electrical energy form. So first we are describing here as a primary cells, means the cell which cannot be recharged, means in which the redox reactions take place only once a time. So there are two types of the primary cells we will discuss here in this video. Primary cell, first is the dry cell, and second one is the mercury cell. This cell is also called button cell, which we generally use in the hearing aids or watches, hand watches. Dry cell, this is the construction. I have made this construction of the dry cell. This one is the metal cap. This one is the graphite electrode. This one is the zinc container, and zinc container is covered with a cardboard. Clear? Zinc container is covered with a cardboard. Outside we have a zinc container, and in the center of the cell we have graphite electrode. Graphite electrode is in contact with the MnO2 and carbon. We have a paste of MnO2 and carbon. While the zinc container is in contact with the ammonium chloride and zinc chloride we have. These two pastes are separated by paper. This one is the seal. We have sealed the said by a pitch. This one is the construction of the cell, dry cell. This metal gap means graphite electrode acts as the cathode, while this zinc container acts as the anode. Zinc container will acts as the anode, while the graphite electrode acts as the cathode. The reaction occurring at the anode means at the zinc. Zinc changes into zinc 2 positive ion by losing the 2 electrons. 2 electrons are used by the zinc. So the oxidation takes place at the anode of zinc. These 2 electrons move from the negative terminal to positive terminal. When we connect this circuit, electrons move from the negative terminal to positive terminal. Spontaneous flow of the electrons from the negative terminal to positive terminal in electrochemical cell. In the cathode, MnO2 plus ammonium ion plus these 2 electrons comes towards the positive graphite electrode, and this MnO2 changes into Mn2O3 plus ammonia plus water. In this, oxidation state of the manganese is plus 4, and in this product form we have plus 3 oxidation state of the manganese. Means manganese is changes into plus 4 to plus 3. Means reduction will be occur here. Manganese changes its oxidation plus 4 to plus 3. One electron is gained, but we have the two manganese gains 2 electrons. So the reduction will take place at the cathode. We can add up these 2 reactions and make the overall reaction. But in the second reduction reaction, we have the ammonia. We get the ammonia. And we know the ammonia is volatile in nature. It will change into gaseous form. And if it changes into the gaseous form, it can build up the pressure inside the cell. And cell may be burst out. So, this NH3 we have to change in another form so that cell will remain safe. Zinc 2 positive ions plus chloride ions plus ammonia. Zinc 2 positive is a transition metal ion which have tendency to form the complex compound. So this NH3 combines with the zinc 2 positive ions and forms the complex compound. This one is a complex compound. Clear? One more. This cell can be dead in a period of the time, whether we use it or not, because this ammonium chloride is acidic in nature. Ammonium chloride is acidic in nature, and this acidic ammonium chloride corrodes the zinc slowly. Zinc will change it into zinc 2 positive ions. A time will be reached when there will be no zinc container. It totally changes into zinc 2 positive ion. In this cell, dry cell give at 1.50 volt. Initially the cell gave this potential, but as the cell start to operate, as the cell give potential drop to 1.25 volt. Because the electrolyte in the cell decreases, this NH4 positive ion changes into the NH3. So this one is the dry cell construction we have, and these are the reaction occurring at the anode and cathode. Now second one is the mercury cell. This cell is also called the button cell, which we use in the hearing aids and in hand watches. Construction is of this cell is this. We have the same graphite electrode, same zinc container. Porous paper we have pasted inside the cell with zinc container. Porous paper as a separator which separates the zinc with KOH and HGO. Paste of the KOH and mercuric oxide. We have the potassium hydroxide and HGO mercuric oxide. We have the paste of this. Same, this graphite will act as the cathode, and this zinc container acts as the anode. Zinc, when comes in contact with the hydroxide ion, it will change into the ZnO, plus water plus 2 electrons. Here the oxidation state of the zinc is 0 and in this oxidation state of the zinc is plus 2. So zinc changes its oxidation state from 0 to plus 2. Means 2 electrons are used. These 2 electrons are used by the zinc. And these electrons move from anode to cathode. Anode to cathode. In the cathode side, we have the graphite electrode is in contact with the HgO. Plus, we have aqueous water plus 2 electrons. And this HgO changes into the Hg, mercury plus OH negative ions. In this oxidation state of the mercury is plus 2. And in this product side, we have 0 oxidation state of the mercury. So, when the mercury changes its oxidation state plus 2 to 0, it gains 2 electrons. Clear? But when we add these to anode and cathode reaction, OH negative ions cancel out, electron to electron cancel out, H2O to H2O cancel out. We have Zn plus HgO changing into ZnO plus Hg. Means in the overall reaction, we have no ions involved. Means concentration of the OH negative ions remains same. Because we use OH negative ions and same amount of the OH negative ions we get back into the cathode reaction. So the concentration of the hydroxide ion remains same. So this cell gives a constant voltage 1.35 volt, because the concentration of electrolyte remains same. Clear? This is the primary cells we have. We have two types, dry cell and mercury cell. In the next video, we will discuss about the secondary cell and then fuel cell. This is all for today. Thank you.